my crop. Step on.
Oh, step on. Okay. No, don't.
Thank you.
I work for all my life.
He loves to share his high energy performance. Keeps the bikers and spectators on the edge of their seats and leaves them begging for more. And we'll see more from these two pilots this morning.
Seeing one another. Meanwhile, turning off and remote and bumping flight conditions are listed. now fly out to the west and set up for their tactical beam approach. This maneuver is done in order to keep the airplane low to the ground and minimize air smoke and to require a while behind them to stay close to the airfield. They will arrive overhead the airplane 200 miles above the ground. 2 seconds after crossing the runway, each airplane will make a coordinated 25-degree right turn.
and the crew in just a moment. And getting ready to take off, coming up a little bit later, the aircraft of Tora, 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 the award-winning show and history lesson, the story we should never forget. These aircraft made for the original movie, Tora, 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 which will include Texas Raiders, the beautifully restored and award-winning B-17 you see taking off now, the very aircraft that will be doing rides out of Abilene Airport tomorrow afternoon. And you can talk to the team about booking one of the rides on that beautifully restored B-17.
Thank you.
airport. You can book a ride on it today. It's how we keep them flying, ladies and gentlemen. Restored and flying these airplanes costs an enormous amount of money. They tell an important history lesson, one we should never forget. So if you want to sit up in the nose, or where the wheelchairs were, or the Bombay, and several other seats on board, they talk to them after they land or at their display area, and they will be happy to have you on board. They're booking two flights this weekend. Taxiing in now. Our C-130 crews, please give them a wave as they taxi by, a show of appreciation. Our pilots cannot hear your appreciation through applause, but they can see it. So we'll ask that you wave your hats, get your hands in the air, and give them a wave of thanking them for their service and showing your appreciation for a job well done today. And while they taxi by, Ron Kane is going to power up his chipmunk, Super Chipmunk. Shortly after that, he's going to shake it out to make sure it's prepared. The aerobatics is going to fly. He will entertain us in the sky. This far, he's been an air show pilot for about 30 years.
We'll end up hand in hand somewhere down on just as free.
Manufactured by a Canadian aircraft manufacturer to Hamlin, Canada, developed shortly after the Second World War and sold heavily throughout the immediate post-war years. It has been a chosen platform of many award-winning performers, including the late Martin Shaw, showmanship is part of the International Council of Engineers, and Freya. It was tragically killed in filming the movie Top Gun. If you recall the movie Top Gun in the end credits, the movie was dedicated to Art Shaw's memory. He was for Chipmunk as well. And now, in these windy conditions, Ron has his hands full recovering this airplane. He'll be landing very shortly, and again, when he taxis by, I want you to give him a huge wave. Local farmer, and he's done so well here, and he loves this country, to be able to perform in front of the military at a base is not lost on him. Ron K.
Japanese aircraft carriers
Soyuz, Soryu, and two new carriers, the Shogokuma Tsukino, less an hour and 45 minutes. When the first bombs began to fall, Army Air Corps pilots Kenneth Taylor and George Welch were just returning from a night on the town. These brave pilots raced to their planes, which were fueled and armed for aerial combat practice, and quickly found themselves in the middle of the real day. The 2 second lieutenants caught up with the Japanese Akima, the Marine Base and Auxiliary Field close to Pearl Harbor and Hickam Field. To the left, you see the B-17. One of the B-17s trying to land at Hickam Field, right in the middle of the attack by the Japanese Zero. After shooting down two Japanese-bound dive bombers, these two brave pilots, Taylor and Welch, ran out of ammunition, landed in Wheeler Field near the center of the island. There, Taylor and Welch reloaded 30 and 50 caliber ammo and took off to fight again. The two Japanese, there goes my script, folks. They were able to bring down six Japanese aircraft before their own planes were disabled. The two received distinguished service crosses for their actions that day. Then came the King torpedo bombers, armed with special shallow running torpedoes, slung beneath the carriage of the torpedoes, diving down, attacking the carriers and all the ships within the harbor and Pearl Harbor. In Pearl Harbor, California, Oklahoma, West Virginia, Tennessee, and Arizona, and the Nevada. The key torpedo bombers hit the Oklahoma. This would take away any claim that the Japanese might have, and this was an attack of opportunity. This was a very well-planned attack. Then came the Val dive bombers, armed with 1,700-pound armor-busting projectiles made for 16-inch battleship guns, but converted to aerial bombs. These planes dived down on the Nevada and Arizona. Anti-aircraft fire cleared the battles away from the Nevada with the first wave, but the Arizona wasn't that lucky. A bomb from the King Bomber stabbed the Arizona through the former magazine and touched off more than 1,000,000 pounds of gunpowder. A sailor on the Nevada watched the Arizona jump at least 15 to 20 feet up in the water and break into two pieces, forever entrapping 1,200 American servicemen in an underwater tomb. The ship sank in less than 15 minutes and remains at the bottom of Pearl Harbor as a memorial to this day. At Marine Corps Air Station Ewa, VFC Melvin Thompson was on guard duty when 9 Zeros, like the one you see in front of you right now, attacked the base. He stepped out of his guard check, drew his 45 caliber handgun, and began firing on the Japanese Zero. The Japanese pilot, Yoshio Shiga, saw Thompson firing back. Years later, Shiga remembered Thompson's tenacity and fighting spirit, describing the Marine as the bravest American I have ever seen. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, again, this is Torah. Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor. We've taken you back to that fateful day of December 7th, 1941. You are there. All over the island, soldiers were bringing their weapons to bear in the fight. Anything they could get working. Their 45 caliber pistols, springfield rifles. In some cases, our soldiers were able to get 30 caliber and 50 caliber belt pin machine guns into action, bringing down numerous marauding Japanese Zeros, Vals, and Kates. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, you can imagine what it must have been like that fateful morning of December 7, 1941, when 183 Japanese Zeros, Vals, and Kates slamming Pearl Harbor and Hickam Field and all over the island of Oahu. They caught us completely by surprise with scraping runs and bombs like you see in front of me right now. And to your left, the B-17 is approaching with only one wheel down. One wheel down, trying to land, damaged by the marauding Japanese Zero, only able to get one gear down, simulating many of those 16 V-17s that were attempting to land unarmed completely on their way in to Pearl Harbor and to Hickam Field. At Bellows Field on the northeast coast of the island, four U.S. Army Air Corps pilots were racing to their P-40s. Just then, Japanese Zeros appeared and started scraping runs.
After this attack, we, the people of the United States, put 16 million men in uniform, built 100,000 fighter aircraft, 98,000 bombers, 24,000 transport planes, 58,000 freighters, 22 aircraft carriers, over 1,000 other floating ships from battleships to submarines, and countless thousands of ground vehicles. Our dedication led to the surrender not only of Japan, but Nazi Germany as well, and freedom for the entire world. We do this in appreciation of that dedication, determination, and effort, and extend our appreciation to the men and women fighting for our freedom today, those folks in uniform here at Dyess Air Force Base. We salute them all, past and present, coming from the right.